Hi, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. Can you tell we're outside? It's January 5th, and we would love to wish everybody, 500,000 people who have viewed our website in 149 countries, a very happy and healthy new year. We thought it'd be fun today to go out and plant in our garden. Start some tomatoes, start some peppers. Not going to happen. Here's my thermometer.
Well, it's only 20 below.
It's 20 below. And we are in a sheltered place right here. But if you're out in the wind, we have a wind chill of between 25 and 45 degrees below zero. So if you're out of the wind, it's really not too bad. Dress properly, but don't get in the wind.
In other words, we're having a heat wave.
We are, right here in this little corner. We thought it'd be fun to try a few things. Our son Sky, the last time it was really cold out, got out our little bubble machine, and he was making bubbles to see how fast they would freeze. Let me put this up. You can catch some on here. It doesn't freeze right there. Okay, let's see if I can catch some. What I'm finding, maybe over here is better. Oops, there they go. If you can catch them, they rise really fast. But when they hit you, they immediately explode. They don't even leave a trace. It's just dust, a frozen dust. And once they get going, they go way, way, way up.
They're like frozen little spheres.
And we
just shatter.
The last time when we were doing this, they get really, if I can get some to land here, they get hard when they land. They're almost like plastic.
It's probably too windy today, which is why we have the wind chill.
But that was a good experiment. The other experiment I wanted to do, they did on the weather forecast in Minnesota someplace, and they put an egg on a plate to see how long it would take. For it to freeze. Now you know the summer experiment where you crack an egg on the sidewalk and it freezes. There we go. Let me check my time here. Let's see how fast it's going. It's 11:46.
So I have to eat breakfast outside today?
You do, and it's going to be crunchy.
Well, what about the song you were singing this morning?
Oh, baby, it's cold outside.
And what happened?
And then you stopped me and said, no, baby, it's really cold outside. Really, really cold. How's it looking? The little strands are frozen. We'll see. In Minnesota, it took 5 minutes. So we'll see. Got 1 minute done. In the meanwhile, I mean, if you can enjoy looking at snow, which is always very pretty. The branches are all bare now, even the oak trees, which usually are the last, and the willow trees, which usually fall off last also.
Well, you were talking about the trees across the street.
Yes, the people across the street have very mature trees. When I had the dogs out, when the wind would make them blow, it was almost like they were cracking. Not breaking off, just cracking in the wind and the cold.
Kind of like tree arthritis?
Maybe. And another thing you find when you're getting down below zero is that your house starts to pop. You'll hear all of these pops and bumps and things you don't normally hear, and you think somebody's trying to bump into your house, but what it is it's the nails popping and come summer, when you're walking on your deck, sure enough, the nails will be up if you've used nails. So it's interesting. The inside of your nose freezes when you breathe in this kind of weather. Let's see. How's it coming? All you can see, the edges are frozen now.
Yeah. And that was. So what are you going to do today? Obviously, you can't start your garden, your 2014 garden outside yet.
No, I can't.
I don't think the peppers and the tomatoes and...
They wouldn't like it at all.
No, I don't think so.
So instead, I think I will plant some mushrooms. I got a mushroom kit for my Christmas present like I had requested, and it's time to start mushrooms again.
Well, let's go in and get some hot cocoa.
Oh, that sounds like a good idea. We'll leave you out here, Eggie. Actually, it took 7 minutes. 7 minutes till it's totally frozen. I don't want to go that way. You can see it's warming up already. Well, it wasn't when I first walked in, but it is now. It's heating up nicely.
Huh. Okay.
Interesting.
Yeah. So how long do you think the body would last?
Well, they said between 10 minutes you'd have frostbite on open skin.
I was talking to a woman this morning and she said she lived 10 minutes away from work, and by the time she got to work her fingers were really frozen. I mean, I'm sure she wore gloves, but I don't know if she walked to work or drove to work. But
Well, if you're in your car and you're only 10 minutes away, your heater probably hasn't kicked in yet.
Yeah.
And the funny thing about when you live in a climate like this, you have multiple winter coats. You don't just have one winter coat. This is Rick's heavy-duty winter coat that he doesn't wear often. But on days like this would be when he would wear it.
Yeah, look who stole my coat.
And then you have your everyday winter coat, and then you'd have specialized winter coats if you were going skiing or if you were going hiking or snowshoeing and ice skating. And then there's your almost winter coat, and then there's your spring coat. So I mean, it just goes on and on. You have closets full of coats.
Well, today you could have worn all four different type of coats under each other and still...
yes.
Yeah.
I've taken the dogs out 4 times now because they can only stay out so long. They can only do one thing at a time, and then they start crying because their feet are cold. So I have to bring them back in, warm them up, take them out again so they can proceed to do something else. And it's not good on dogs.
Well, why don't you make yourself some hot tea, and we'll get things ready in the mushrooms, and we'll take it from there.
Sounds good. Oh yes, this is much better. It's 70 in here. So there's a 90 degree difference between inside and out. And that's a good thing because my new mushrooms want to be 70 or even above. I'm drinking my cocoa while we talk.
So you got a mushroom kit, huh?
I got a mushroom kit. It's the white button mushrooms. I really like those. This particular company also has the cremini, portobello, and the shiitake, and the oyster. But we've only ever use the white button because we like them. If you do buy a mushroom kit, be sure you get one that is fresh. You don't want to get one that's outlived its strength. Probably it would grow some, but not as many as is potential to grow.
So it has an expiration date.
It does. Mm-hmm. Just like seeds, you know, they last so long and then they lose their potency.
So is it like a live culture?
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And before I even get started on mushrooms, you know, why would a person even want to have mushrooms? Some people love the taste of them. Some people can't stand it. They can't stand the texture.
I love them with my eggs.
There are so many reasons that mushrooms are good. I had to write them down. For one thing, mushrooms are like us. They absorb things from the environment, from the air, from the soil, from what they touch. So you want to be careful when you're working with your mushrooms. You need to wash your hands before you start and any utensils you're going to use. Mushrooms, fungi, produce antibiotics. We all knew that from penicillin, but they also create streptomycin and tetracycline. Who knew? I mean, they are able
what
to
the
make...
What the heck are those?
Those are antibiotics.
Oh, okay.
They make their own antibiotics.
Thought you're doing one of those commercials, you know.
Mushrooms improve your immune system. White button mushrooms are low in calories. They're high in protein. They have enzymes in them. They have the B vitamins, especially niacin. And they have vitamin D2, which is what you get from the sun. So all these good things. There are antioxidants, which all mushrooms have, but some of them have there's a very unique antioxidant, and I have to read it off of here. Ergothionine.
Which
is the master antioxidant of all time. And it protects your DNA from oxidizing. Now, don't you want your DNA protected from oxidizing? Yeah, you want rusty DNA?
Well, I need to eat things that I can pronounce.
Mushrooms are also anti-inflammatory, anti-cancer, and they protect your body if you need chemo or radiation. So why not have mushrooms? And it doesn't take that many. You can eat one little... white button mushroom a day, and you would get the benefits of it. And if you can't stand the taste of it, you can buy the powder and pills. Just be sure you get your kit from an organic mushroom farm. If you buy them in the store, be sure they're organic, because again, they absorb what's around them.
Well, you get this from a garden center not too far from here. We were going to order some online, but it costs more to ship it because, I mean, that
you're buying a box of dirt, soil, if you must. But yes, if you can get it from somebody locally, that would be best. Sometimes they have them at
the farmers
markets.
Market, yeah.
Right, the indoor farmers market here in Milwaukee does sell this. This company is at that farmers market, and they do sell them.
Now, they're at the Mitchell Domes over our winter months here in Wisconsin.
Mm-hmm. They're there every Saturday morning from 9 till 1.
So what's in a kit?
When you get a kit, it's heavy.
That's got to be about, 15 pounds or so?
Oh, yeah, at least.
Maybe 20?
And you get two bags, okay? You get the bag. The big bag is where the mushrooms already are, okay?
So the spores?
You roll this back. Yes, they're in there already.
Oh, yeah. That's very fragrant.
Mm-hmm. It smells like mushrooms. Mm. Now, you don't want to mess with it too much. They said you could just kind of move it around a little bit. I don't even see that I need to do that. It all looks pretty good. It hasn't been tumbled. You cannot divide it in half and move it that much. That would disturb them, so don't do that. This bag has peat moss in it. It has some water in it, and also some, what is my word I want? I've just lost it.
You're lost for words?
What's in the second bag? Oh, crushed limestone. I knew there was something that I was familiar with. This is what the mushrooms will grow in. So it'll come up through this.
So you just dump that right on top?
Right on top. And again, wash your hands before you start this. Any utensils you're going to use, wash those, because if they've been contaminated with dirt or germs or whatever, that will transfer. Don't want that in. So I've washed my little Reiki thing. I'm just moving it around, and it's going to take about 4 days, but it could take up to 14 days for the mycelium, which is the actual growth of the mushroom, to work its way up into this peat moss mixture. Okay, and to do that, it needs to be in a warm environment. 70 degrees, 76 degrees is perfect. Now I'm going to close this up, not tight, tightly, just a little bit. Leave a little hole here at the top. And I'm going to put it right on the floor in the dining room, and we'll check it. Now what you should do is mark on the box what day you started this. So we started it today is the 6th, and then we'll check it in about 4 days and see what's happened. Once you see that the about a third to 25% or more is covered with the white mycelium, then it moves downstairs, you open it up, and they start sprouting. That's exciting.
They sprout pretty quickly.
They do.
This is a great project to do as a family. I mean, especially during wintertime, if you love gardening, just bringing that smell in the house is wonderful. I mean, it's like, well, it
like
gets the gardening juices
it's
going. Yeah, it's very earthy.
And if you don't like, you know, you think your kids aren't going to like to eat mushrooms, you can hide them. Last time we did this, I made mushroom cookies and mushroom cake, and you could never have tasted the mushroom in there at all, but the benefits are still there.
Well, plus I think when kids get to see, well, anybody, adult too, when you get to actually see where things come from, you're more likely to try them and
yes.
eat them, and then it's up to you to be creative and find different ways
of
preparing them.
Right. I mean, they're so good just fresh. If a child would see how it grows from a tiny little white dot into a perfect little round mushroom that absolutely looks like something you'd find in a cartoon, you can't help but at least taste it.
Well, think of the delicious mushroom sauce on a nice filet or even in a stir fry, you know, something.
Yes.
I mean,
and I
know.
Just found today 3 recipes for versions of mushroom soup, so we're going to be trying that.
Oh,
and this time
great.
Also, I am going to be drying them.
That's a good
time
idea, huh?
I didn't even think about drying them, and now that I have my dryer and I've used it extensively, drying them will be perfect. This kit should produce mushrooms for about 60 to 90 days.
Yeah.
So that'll give us a good
supply.
Well,
I remember the last kit we had. My goodness, I mean, some of them turned into
portobellos. Yes,
yeah.
Well, that's the thing with this button mushroom kit. You can use them when they're tiny little buttons. You can let them grow bigger. They are the cremini size, and if you let them grow all the way till the vents open on the bottom, they're portobellos, which you can make burgers out of because they're just huge.
Yeah.
So...
Now, have you ever tried mushroom powder?
No, but that's what they put in the capsules for people that don't like to eat them.
Yeah.
So
well, maybe we'll dry some and grind it up into a powder
mm-hmm.
form too. So.
Sure. You could use that in a gravy or a meat sauce.
Yeah.
Sounds good to me.
Okay, so this is phase one of our mushroom kit, and we'll keep you posted on its progress. And.
Right.
You know, I can't wait to start seeing them grow. I know it happens quickly once they get started.
That's right. And a mushroom can grow twice its size in one day. So
yeah.
You have to keep watching when they all turn into portobellos.
Well, that's not so bad either.
No, it isn't.
Okay, well.
Go. Give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, the frozen part and the mushroom part. And we'd love to hear from you. We'd love to have you subscribe to us also.
And for those of you who've never been in cold weather, this is cold even for Wisconsin.
It is. It's been a long time since it's been this cold.
Yeah.
But we can handle it.
Freeze the nostril hairs in a matter of seconds.
Bye for now.
Oh, I love the smell of that soil. Delicious.